More now on that warning from ICU nurses in New South Wales. Their open letter to Premier Gladys Berejiklian revealing the impact of chronic understaffing on patient care as COVID hospital admissions reach crisis point.
And joining us now is Brett Holmes from the state's Nurses and Midwives Association. Brett, thanks for your time this morning. I mean, just reading this letter that you've written to the Premier, and I'll just give you the first line. Given the chronic unsafe staffing conditions exacerbated by COVID-19, we cannot deliver the care you expect. Pretty powerful words.
That's right. The intensive care nurses have been calling out, even before this latest wave of COVID-19, for improved staffing in the intensive care units. Unfortunately, the Ministry of Health and ultimately the government didn't want to listen when this was raised with them earlier in the year, certainly in around March and April. The message was given to the Ministry of Health. Intensive care nurses were reaching out then for further assistance for proper staffing in their intensive care units.
So when we hear and see the Premier of New South Wales and other health officials, Chief Health Officer, say, it's okay, we've got this, we've got enough staff, is that right or wrong?
Well, what they're working on is a plan to introduce more staff from the rest of the system into the intensive care capacity. There were a number of people who undertook upskilling last year when it looked like we would need more ventilator in use in our intensive cares, and of course that requires more staff. The concerns from our intensive care members in the interim was that all of those people disappeared and they certainly weren't available when short staffing was occurring in our intensive care units. So the level of exasperation by our intensive care members that they were told that there were all these people who were upskilled, but when they were short staffed, there were nowhere to be found. So the Premier has been indicating that things will be done differently, and clearly a different model of care is being proposed with spreading out of the intensive care experienced nurses using some of the nurses who have upskilled. And whilst we understand we're in the middle of a crisis and the intensive care nurses have been working extraordinary amount of additional hours, they want to be able to sit down with the Premier and the Minister for Health at the end of this and get a commitment to make sure that our intensive care units across New South Wales will be properly staffed with the right numbers of nurses for the patients that they're looking after.
So it feels like what you're basically saying is you don't believe that the staffing requirements will be there when the hospital system is really under pressure. How are you feeling about what's to come when we're hearing that we'll see, you know, 1,000 cases a day in ICU?
We are asking for more detail about what their plan intends, and certainly we know that that planning has been underway. It's not been a matter.
I think we've lost him there, and we'll leave it be. But there can't have been more serious, that letter from the ICU nurses to the state Premier. And they went on to say, we're extremely concerned about our ability to provide safe nursing care under the current staffing levels afforded by the New South Wales government to ICUs around this state. And given what Ali just said then about those numbers increasing potentially to more than 1,000 in ICU, I mean, that's going to place extreme pressure on the system. They've been handling it, the New South Wales government. We've seen this happen in Victoria as well, and the staffing levels were definitely tested. But this is going to be a huge test, a monumental test in the next few weeks for our nursing staff and all of our nursing people and our health authorities, especially under the pump already. So I think it's worthy of the New South Wales government taking a very close look at this.
And for us, I think we sit here and go, well, how is there this disconnect? How have you got nurses on the front line saying, hang on, no, we're already stressed, we're not going to cope, but you've got health bureaucrats and the government saying, so what is the truth? And we're in the meantime, you know, pushing people to get vaccinated, because what we don't want to see is 1,000 people in ICU in New South Wales.